On behalf of the Rural Independence Deputy, Danny Healy-Ray, who's 3 minutes.
Thank you very much, Les Cloncaller. I want to raise with you, Taoiseach, today the policy that they have around demountable homes and rural cottages, the provision of to help people in rural Ireland. These demountable homes, first of all, were vital where the old farmhouse or the old house fell into disrepair and became unhabitable for 50 or 60 year olds or indeed older, and who in any circumstance would not or could not leave their own place. They want to stay in the place where they were born and raised. And all of these would provide a site for a demountable home. Indeed, Councillor Johnny Healy-Ray said at last Monday's Kerry County Council meeting that these people would only leave their place in a hearse, and that is a fact issue. These units would give, and always did give them, comfort, a bit of heat, security, safe from the elements and vermin. Then the rural cottages. In Kerry, we've only 3 been built in the last 9 years. And from 2016 to 2021, 10 are to be built. And there are 35 to 40 more people on the waiting list for these rural cottages. These people would provide a site of their own. They want to live near their parents, and they want to live near their family, and to work on their farm. And the department have agreed to fund only 10 of these until 2021. Do we have any funding for housing, Taoiseach? I asked if he hadn't to spell it out to us and we'd all understand. But clearly these people are providing almost half the cost of housing themselves. They're providing the site. In 2015, he announced $62.5 million for housing in Kerry. He never told us when it was going to be spent by. Is it going to last to 2030? Rural cottages have been an integral part of rural Ireland since the foundation of the state, and in particular since the 1960s. The decision by is this in line with the famous 2040 plan where people will only get planning in rural areas if permission will only be granted if it won't detract from the greater urban areas? I'll give you an instance. Kerry County Council granted permission to a person to build a house in their own place, and being a favoured NEFU. And it was appealed to Bord Pleanála by one of these serial objectors. Bord Pleanála came back and said that 6 kilometres where he was proposing to build his house was too far away to go to his place of work. That is a fact. These rural cottages almost always finished up cost neutral, as tenants almost always bought them as they were on their own land and they wouldn't like to see anyone else coming into their own land. It was really only a loan, as the house would be built to standard, and when people got on their feet they bought them out. Are you trying to move all the people into Dublin or into the to urban areas? That's what I'm asking.
Taoiseach, 3 minutes.
Yeah, I'm afraid I can't comment in great detail about the precise situation in the Deputy's County, as I'm not fully briefed on it. And he might explain to me a bit better about demountable homes. It's not a term I'm familiar with, perhaps one I should be familiar with. In terms of the broader picture, at the moment, across Ireland, 18,000 new homes have commenced construction in the past year. And that's a really big increase. We had a period of 7 years during which almost no new homes were built in Ireland because the government couldn't afford to build social housing and because the banks and the construction industry were on the floor. So we're very much playing catch-up. We've a lot to catch up on. But with 18,000 new homes commenced construction in the past year, we're now building more new homes in Ireland than at any point in about 7 years. And we need to ramp that up to about 25,000 next year and 35,000 the year ahead. Also last year, we added about 7,000 new homes to our social housing stock through various different mechanisms, direct build, approved housing bodies, leases, voids and others. And we're at another 8,000 or just under 8,000 this year. So we're ramping that up again and increasing supply of social housing. In terms of funding, and you mentioned funding specifically, €6 billion is being provided for investment in housing between now and 2021. So that's an enormous investment in housing between now and 2021. We'll deliver about 110,000 extra social housing units for people to live in between now and 2021. So that's a huge uplift, if you like, in investment. Separate to this, as you know, under Project Ireland 2040, we've set out a plan for the nation, a plan for a country with a million more people living here by 2040. And with most of those, most of that growth happening outside of Dublin, the other cities growing twice as fast as Dublin, an extra 200,000 people living in rural Ireland. And indeed tomorrow, Minister Ring will announce further details of the €1 billion Rural Regeneration Fund, which is going to be deployed over the next decade.
1 minute.
It's very clear to me that you no understand it all of what I'm talking about. And at last Monday's meeting, Councillor Johnny Healy-Ray got a reply that the local authority must clearly demonstrate that the proposed demountable unit is required on foot of a genuine emergency, either a fire or a flood. But I have to point out to you, Minister, that there are many people who reach the age of 60 or maybe even older. Their house has fallen into disrepair. They will not leave the place where they were born and reared. And all they're asking for is a demountable home to be placed on a site and even connected to their own septic tank. It is very clear, Minister for Housing, I'm asking you to examine this. It's not fair to deny these people the right to stay where they were born and reared. And likewise, the rural cottages. To think that there are 35 people going to have applicants have to wait for 5 more years before they'll be housed, if they will at all, in the rural place where they want to live, on their farms and close to their pens. We want to move them all into the large urban areas. I can't understand why. These people have their own water, they have their own septic tanks, and they're burdening no one. But he can't see as far as he knows. This is the place they want to be. And he will get back the funding when they get in their feet and are able to buy out the house again.
Deputy Hillary-Ray, please, you must respect.
I know last John Corley, but this is a very serious matter for the people that are in the circumstances applying and looking for a demountable home.
Taoiseach, 3 minutes.
I'm informed by one of my colleagues here that demountable homes are prefabricated homes, which is what they're called in Fingal, and can be constructed on site. I'm told it is an option for local authorities. Ultimately, it's for local authorities to come forward with those proposals. €6 billion is allocated in Project Ireland 2040 for the investment in social housing over the next 10 years. Investment in social housing is ramping up dramatically. Just to give you a rough idea of the figures, 657 direct builds, that increased to 2,434 last year. Acquisitions 1,250 last year, leasing 600 last year, and more ambitious targets again for this year. So there's a lot of money being invested in social housing, €6 billion set aside for the next 10 years, and it is up to local authorities to come forward with proposals to the Department of Housing, Planning and Local Government. And if Kerry County Council wants to come forward with proposals for demountable homes or prefabricated dwellings, Minister Murphy and his department will certainly consider them.
You
know the rules, Deputy Hillary-Ray, please.
It's a bit late now. We now move on to the